Good morning. Today we are going to solve free response question number 2 from the 2019 AP Physics 1 exam. Billy, please read the problem through part AI.
Flippin' physics.
This problem explores how the relative masses of two blocks affect the acceleration of the blocks. Block A of mass M sub A rests on a horizontal tabletop. There is negligible friction between block A and the tabletop. Block B of mass M sub B hangs from a light string that runs over a pulley and attaches to block A as shown. The pulley has negligible mass and spins with negligible friction about its axle. The blocks are released from rest. Part AI. Suppose the mass of block A is much greater than the mass of block B. Estimate the magnitude of the acceleration of the blocks after release. And there is a space for our estimate. Then it says, briefly explain your reasoning without deriving or using equations. So this must be the quantitative, qualitative translation question on this exam, right, Mr. P?
Does light string mean the mass of the string is also negligible?
Yes, Billy, this is the quantitative, qualitative translation question for this exam. And yes, Bobby, saying the string is light means the mass of the string is negligible. Bo, could you please answer this question?
Sure. Let's actually start with my explanation. Block A is so massive that it has enough inertia to almost completely resist the relatively small tension force in the string, which is caused by the relatively small force of gravity on block B. Therefore, I would estimate that the magnitude of the acceleration of block A after release is nearly zero. That's it.
Thanks, Bo. Bobby, please read and answer part A double I.
Now suppose the mass of block A is much less than the mass of block B. Estimate the magnitude of the acceleration of the blocks after release. And then the blank space for our answer, and briefly explain your reasoning without deriving or using equations. Oh, right, because this is the quantitative, qualitative translation question. You know, I like starting with the explanation, Bo. That is a good idea.
Thanks.
So, in the absence of block A, block B would be in free fall and have an acceleration of 9.81 meters per second squared down. The relatively small mass of block A only causes a small tension force up on block B to decrease the magnitude of block B's acceleration slightly. That means that my estimate is the magnitude of the acceleration of block A after release is nearly 9.81 meters per second squared.
Very nice, Bobby. Billy, please read and answer part B.
Part B. Now suppose neither block's mass is much greater than the other, but that they are not necessarily equal. The dots below represent block A and block B as indicated by the labels. On each dot, draw and label the forces, not components, exerted on that block after release. Represent each force by a distinct arrow starting on and pointing away from the dot. Okay, both blocks have a force of gravity acting down on them, and they should have subscripts A and B on them. Block A is on the table and has a force normal acting perpendicular to the surface and up on it. And then the two ends of the string each have the same magnitude force of tension on them. The tension force on block A is to the right. The tension force on block B is up. And there is no friction or any other forces. So those are complete free body diagrams.
Thank you, Billy. Those free body diagrams look good. And I'll read part C. Part C. Derive an equation for the acceleration of the blocks after release in terms of mass of block A, mass of block B, and physical constants as appropriate. If you need to draw anything other than what you have shown in part B to assist in your solution, use the space below. Do not add anything to the figure in part B. So that last part is a typical warning on these exams. Please remember, when they ask for free body diagrams or force diagrams, they want them without components, and your free body diagrams are answers. So do not make changes to them after you draw them. If you need to break forces into components and redraw the free body diagram, do that in a different location than the free body diagram answer. So let's solve for the acceleration of the blocks after release. Who's got some ideas?
We could use conservation of energy to solve for the final velocities of both blocks after they have gone a certain distance, and then use a uniformly accelerated motion equation to solve for the acceleration of both blocks.
We could sum the forces on block A in the x and y directions, and then sum the forces on block B in the y direction, and then combine those equations.
We could sum the forces on both blocks at the same time and solve for the acceleration of both blocks simultaneously.
Those are all equally valid ways of solving this problem. Let's go with Bo's solution because it is probably the most efficient, though I do want to be clear they are all correct. Bo, please?
Sure. Let's define the positive direction as to the right on block A and down on block B because the string changes the direction, right? And then sum the forces on both blocks in that positive direction. That net force equals the force of gravity acting on block B, which is positive because it is in the positive direction. Then minus the force of tension, which acts on block B, plus the force of tension, which acts on block A. The normal force and force of gravity on block A are not in our net force equation because they act perpendicularly to our positive direction. The two tension forces cancel one another out because they are equal in magnitude. The net force also equals mass times acceleration, and that is the total mass of both blocks A and block B because we summed the forces on both blocks. The force of gravity on block B equals mass of block B times acceleration due to gravity, and we can solve for the acceleration of both blocks. It equals the quantity mass of block B divided by the quantity mass of block A plus mass of block B, all multiplied by acceleration due to gravity.
Thanks, Bo. Bobby, please read and answer part D.
Part D. Consider the scenario from part A, double I, where the mass of block A is much less than the mass of block B. Does your equation for the acceleration of the blocks from part C agree with your reasoning in part A, double I? Yes or no? Briefly explain your reasoning by addressing why, according to your equation, the acceleration becomes, or approaches, a certain value when the mass of block A is much less than the mass of block B. Well, we should write, if the mass of block A is much less than the mass of block B, then the quantity mass of block B divided by the quantity mass of block A plus mass of block B is nearly 1. And therefore, the magnitude of the acceleration of both blocks is nearly equal to g, or 9.81 meters per second squared. So put a mark next to yes, because our answer for C does agree with our estimate from part B, double I.
Thank you, Bobby. Now, I will point out that part D is worth 1 point, and you can get that 1 point with a no answer, as long as you give valid reasoning that addresses the result in part C and the reasoning in part A double I. Billy, please read and answer part E.
Part E. While the blocks are accelerating, the tension in the vertical portion of the string is T sub 1. Next, the pulley of negligible mass is replaced with a second pulley whose mass is not negligible. When the blocks are accelerating in this scenario, the tension in the vertical portion of the string is T sub 2. How do the two tensions compare to each other? Tension 1 is greater than tension... No, I'm sorry. Tension 2 is greater than tension 1. Tension 2 equals tension 1, or tension 2 is less than tension 1. Briefly explain your reasoning. Okay. I would say the addition of a pulley with non-negligible mass will increase the resistance of the system to change in velocity, and therefore the new acceleration will be less than the original acceleration. We can sum the forces on block B to determine how this affects the tension force. So we sum the forces on block B in the positive direction. That equals force of gravity on block B minus force of tension. Net force also equals mass times acceleration. Because we summed the forces on just block B, that is just the mass of block B. Therefore, the force of tension equals the force of gravity on block B minus mass of block B times the acceleration of the blocks. Okay. So when the acceleration is smaller, according to our equation, the force of tension is actually larger. Cool. So, right, Therefore, when acceleration is decreased, the tension force is increased. So put a check next to tension 2 is greater than tension 1. Mr. P, why did you write F sub T for tension when in the problem it is just T?
Billy, the reason I write F sub T is to remind you that it is the force of tension. Notice that each time you read the variable T, you simply said tension. You never called that a tension force. I want you to always remember which variables are forces, so I always write every force with a capital F and then a subscript indicating which force it is. That's just me trying to help your brains remember what all these letters mean.
Okay, that makes sense. Thank you.
All right, another note about grading. Part E is worth 2 points, and you can get 1 point even if you mark the incorrect tension force comparison, as long as the physics of your argument is sound. In other words, you can get the wrong answer and still get half the points. Please, answer every part of every question. You never know what will get you points. However, not answering the question is certain to get you 0 points. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.